Hello guys, this is Vinita Kumar. You're watching me on India.com and Bollywood Live. So, you know, we are, it's been a year since remembering Sushant. And to celebrate his legacy today, we have got with us Tahir Raj Basin, who worked with him in Chichore, fabulous, fabulous film. So thank you, Tahir, for joining us and for taking our time to talk about somebody who's been so dear to all of us, at least in this last year. So, you know, thank you for doing this.
Hi, Vinita. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so you know, Tahir, we're talking about Sushant. You know, so what are your best memories with him? You know, just what do you think when you just first think about Sushant?
Right, Vinita. I'd like to start with saying that this would possibly be the first time in 1 year ever since his passing that I'm doing an interview where I'm speaking about Sushant, and I think that this is very important to put out. Purely because I feel like, and like the way people dealt with his passing, maybe it was an emotional reaction, maybe it was a sad reaction, maybe it was an angry reaction, I found was in a way taking away from what an artist should be remembered for. And it was for that very specific reason that one never knew what the true motives of someone who is going to be speaking about him and taking his name, I'm talking about 1 year ago this time, would really right. want from a co-actor. I'm someone who spent shooting Chichore with him. We shot on and off for about a year, and that was the last project that he shot for. The other film that released after Chichore was actually shot before Chichore. Its release was delayed. So Chichore was the last film that he did. And I think by the nature of the part that I played in that film, we were supposed to have the bonding of very close friends.
Right.
We were never friends before the film. And unfortunately, soon after the film, he passed away. But I think when you play a part, there is something about fiction that seeps into reality as well. And your bonding on set and off set tends to reflect what the script has in it, and to a large extent that happened. So I'm happy today that we're going to be speaking about how an artist should be remembered rather than the tamasha that happened after. And I have no other words for what happened. I don't even want to dignify it by mentioning everything that took place. But for me, he was just an incredibly passionate and an incredibly committed co-star.
Yeah. So, you know, I mean, of course, we know that, you know, he belonged to the movies, you know, he was an actor, he was a star, and he belonged there on the sets. Could you just share a few anecdotes or some incidents where you realized that, you know, he belonged to the sets, you know, like the incidents that actually made you realize that?
He was a 90s buff, and I know this because Chichore, the college throwbacks, where we're playing the younger parts of the film, was set in the 90s. Okay. And so there was always a 90s music that was playing in the vanity van. We had a common makeup area during the time. And there was always like great music. He was an excellent mimic. He was an excellent dancer. And he was very spontaneous. So there were times when a song would be playing and all of a sudden you would see him like go into Shah Rukh mode. Some days he would come in Hrithik mode. It was really what his mood and what the scene of that day required. And I remember him bringing that energy of being the senior actor, the senior star on set. And it was just very motivating to see.
Yeah. So, you know, what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of Sushant Tahir?
I think self-made is the first thing that comes to my mind. It was just phenomenal because I remember the very first part that I did in a film. It was a 5-minute part. It was a film called Kai Poche.
Right.
And he was starring in that film at the time. And it was the first film set that I had ever been on. And I remember watching that scene with him in the vanity van. It was a great throwback for both of us because he was like, oh my God, that was you. Or yeah, of course it was you. And we watched that scene and it was very generous of him to play that scene, watch it. He made everyone on set watch it. And from there, the journey that he had gone through from a Kaipoche, which was his first Bollywood break after working in television, to the parts that he picked, and how someone who started off, you have to remember, as a background dancer, like as a as a, as a dancer who worked in a troupe, and then worked his way up into television stardom, and then film stardom, and achieved more goals than most people would achieve in two lifetimes.
Okay, so do you think that, you know, Sushant was beyond Bollywood in some sense? Like was he a different kind of actor in the mainstream scene? Do you think that?
He was, I remember him putting in a lot of thought into the part that he was doing. And I think what set him apart just from any other actor who I've worked with is that his world and his life was a lot more than just acting. When you had conversations with Sushant, they could range from astrophysics to quantum gravity to you know, the playing the sitar to martial arts. He just had a lot of diverse interests, and that's what made him incredibly interesting. Is that you never got bored around it. There would be days when he would say, "Acha, aaj shooting jaldi pack up hogi, hum ghar jayenge," and then we would be at his place. He had a massive telescope in his house, and you could watch the stars, as he often loved to do. He loved to play table tennis. So there was so much more to his personality is what really set him apart. Because very often you meet great actors, you meet great stars, but then they are 100% films, and that's all they're about. He was films and so much more, so much bigger.
Yeah. So what are the roles that actually you think that, you know, that those were meant for Sushant, and, you know, that actually, if you want to see and through, just look back through to his journey, you realize that, you know, these are the best roles that he has done. And, you know, maybe in the future, if you get a chance, I would also, you know, do something on those lines. What are those roles?
I don't at this stage want to pick out particular roles, because I think that would be unfair to his entire filmography. But what I do remember him for is that he would pick the story and not the part. And if you think about it, whether he had a passion for sport, which is why he did Dhoni, which was one of his most successful films. And even if you look at a Chichore, it was an ensemble film, in the sense that although he led that ensemble, but the story was about everyone. And you have to be a very secure star to pick a part like that so early in your career. At the stage where he was picking films, he must have had about 7 to 10 films on his table. But to pick a Chichore because of the message that that film had, I think says a lot about the kind of person that he was. And I want to I want everyone listening to this to remember him for the things that were mentioned, for the fact that he was self-made, for the fact that his intelligence was far superior than what one part or one film could ever reveal to us. And also the choices that he made were intentionally unusual. Like, there was no stopping him from doing the down-the-line hero roles after where he was. But he chose films that were different, that tried to be out of the box. And these are the things that I would like to remember him for.
Yeah. So, okay, Tahir, my last question to you. How did you get to know about him passing away? What were you doing? Where were you?
It was the lockdown. I remember I was in my kitchen. I was cooking lunch at the time. It was like the 15 minutes in the day when I wasn't with my phone. And I got a call from home to say, "Are you okay?" And I didn't know why they were asking. And then they broke the news to me, ironically, because I wasn't with my phone. And then I got to my phone and there were 100 messages. And it was, as it is, we were living in dark times back 1 year ago, just like we are today. But to get news like that about someone you just, you respect it so much, it just devastating for me, for the fans, for his family, for everyone.
On that note, Tahir, thank you so very much for talking to us. And I thought it was going to be okay, but I think it's going to be hard now. So thank you. And Sushant lives. So I hope he lives.
Thank you. On that note, Vinita, thank you for having me.
Thank you.